How much power did Piccolo gain between the Frieza Saga and Cell Saga of Dragon Ball Z? In this video, we're going to discuss that. Hey guys, according to YouTube, the majority of you who are watching this video right now are not subscribed to my channel. So I ask you to go ahead and subscribe right now, as well as enabling notifications. That way, you can see all of my videos right away when they come out. And it also helps this channel to grow so I can bring you even more content in the future. With that being said, let's get back to the video. So joining me in this video is someone you've seen on my channel in the past, and his name is...
What's up guys, MJ here. Thank you for having me back on the channel, Mike.
So, first off, we're gonna have to start with Piccolo's power on Namek to establish the initial power, which eventually led to the power we're going to be discussing.
So, people have to understand when it comes to Piccolo arriving on Namek that he had a pretty big increase in terms of strength. Now, a reason for this would be the last time we saw him was during the Saiyan Saga losing to Nappa. And Nappa had a power level of anywhere between 4 to maybe 5,000, maybe even 6, depending on how much you want to wank him due to his performance against Goku as Goku started to try a little bit more towards the end of their fight. Now, anyways, going back to Piccolo, the fact that he was losing to Nappa and the fact that he would show up on Namek pretty confident in combating not only Frieza, but knowing that Vegeta's also on that planet and knowing just how strong everyone else has gotten would tell you that he is very powerful. And a good example of this is the fact that Nail was very impressed with how strong Piccolo was, almost confused and, whoa, what type of training did you do? How did you get so powerful? I'm a warrior Namekian, but you're like, wow, what are you? And that could give an indication that he could be relative to the Ginyu level. He could also even be stronger than that, maybe even close to base Goku. And a good reason for this is because of Frieza. Frieza having a power level of over 500,000 pretty much just stomped Nail, but yet Nail's very impressed by Piccolo. So if you guys wanted to use numbers and get all crazy with math, you could imply that Piccolo bare minimum got about 15 to maybe even 20 times stronger.
Yeah, like you said before, Frieza specifically told Nail, I have a power level of 530,000 and he easily decimated Nail. But then Nail was still at the same time sensing the power of Goku with Kaioken fighting against Captain Ginyu. And then after that, he sends Frieza going to full power against Vegeta, and Gohan and Krillin, whose power increased throughout the arc ever since Guru unleashed their hidden potential. So this means that for Nail to, instead of just being like, hey Piccolo, you're basically fodder, why are you even here? For him to say to Piccolo, your power is incredible. I don't know what kind of training you've been doing, but you're definitely the Namekian they told me about, goes to show you that Piccolo had some significant gains on King Kai's planet. And it's even more impressive when we consider the fact that Piccolo is only on King Kai's planet for like 6 days. Because we're first told about when he arrived with the other Z fighters by King Kai when Goku is on his way to Namek. So that's not only ridiculous, but it goes to show you that this guy gets big gains. But of course, during the Frieza Saga, Goku unleashed his Super Saiyan form. And after the planet was destroyed and Piccolo and the others were back on Earth, Goku was training on Yordrat, which he was on for over a year, possibly close to 2 years, considering how it's phrased in the manga. So a question is, during this period of time, did Piccolo get even more powerful?
So to understand how strong Piccolo was during the time Goku was on Yordrat and around the time Frieza and King Cole would arrive to the planet, you have to look back at his merging with Nail. After merging with Nail, he became around the level of second form Frieza, if not a tiny bit stronger, then of course was completely outclassed by Frieza's third transformation. But on Earth, it's kind of hard to say how strong he would have gotten. Yeah, Piccolo does train constantly. I've talked about this in numerous videos, and so has Mike. Piccolo is a character that is like the Saiyans, where they train constantly every single day trying to improve themselves. Funny enough, we even get a scene where Gohan talks to Piccolo and Piccolo lets him know that living a life on Namek would be just way too boring for him, and he trains every single day. Which is the case that makes you wonder just how much stronger did he get from his time on Namek. He could have gotten stronger, but probably not by much, because everybody is sensing King Cold and Frieza's arrival, and we find out later that Frieza wasn't even at his full potential. He was still suppressing his power in his final form mecha state that he had, and he did not use that power until later later when he battled Trunks. This is also backed up by Gohan, who says Frieza gets even way stronger. So even the amount of time that Piccolo had to train and to increase his strength, it's still pretty much telling us that he would not have been able to beat or even combat this suppressed form of Frieza, because he was pretty much terrified once he saw the ship land on Earth.
Yeah, another thing to consider is that when someone trains on their own, they're typically not going to receive the same amount of gains that they would receive if they trained with a training partner, or if they trained specifically with someone much stronger, which is something we're going to get into shortly. However, I think another thing worth mentioning is that when Goku arrives back on the planet and finds out that Frieza's been killed, he asks both Piccolo and Vegeta, "Oh, who beat Frieza? Was it you, Piccolo? Or maybe Vegeta?" So I think that this probably goes to show that Piccolo did get stronger, but like you said, it's not going to make any sense for Piccolo to suddenly be stronger than Final Form Frieza on Namek or something, especially considering he's just been training on his own under normal Earth gravity for like a year and a half or 2 years. So I think it's probably also Goku just guessing because he has no idea who Trunks is, and he also isn't going to somehow know Piccolo and Vegeta's full power when he's been gone for so long. But of course, Goku also got stronger on Yardrat when he was training with the Yardratians and learned how to tap into Super Saiyan at will there. And shortly after he reveals this, and Trunks explains that the androids are going to arrive in 3 years and they're going to kill all the Z fighters, Goku, Piccolo, and Gohan begin to train. Now, the fact that Piccolo and even the humans begin to train for this purpose shows that they believe that even though this threat seems incredible, they might have the potential to be able to overcome it. And eventually, after the 3 year gap, we do see all of these people showing up to fight against the androids, who Trunks, as a Super Saiyan, said that had already defeated him and already killed their future counterparts. So I think this goes to suggest that all of them would have gotten a significant boost in power. However, I think based upon what we see with Piccolo, not only during the training, where we see that Piccolo in the anime is fighting evenly against Space Goku, and then in the manga, we even see that Goku is sparring as a Super Saiyan against both Piccolo and Gohan. So that goes to show you that clearly he wouldn't have been using that form when he can't even suppress it as much as he can later in the arc against people who are that much weaker than him.
I think people have to understand by this point in the story, at least at the start of the Android Saga, is that Piccolo is above Super Saiyan level, or at least relative to that. And what I mean by that is something that you had just said literally a second ago. And that's the fact that Piccolo was an advocate of, if you don't get strong enough to help us fight this threat, do not show up. He repeated that over and over to the humans. If you don't think you can do anything against these guys who can beat up a guy who just one-shotted Frieza and his father, do not show up. So I'm pretty sure that Piccolo, who had training partners in a Super Saiyan Goku and in a Gohan with all the potential in the world, he knew what the ceiling was. In his head, he knew that he needed to surpass Super Saiyan Trunks. At the very least, Final Form Frieza and Super Saiyan Goku on Namek, but it makes more sense that he would need to surpass Trunks after witnessing what Trunks did to Frieza. But overall, it's safe to say that he is stronger than like the Namek arc Super Saiyans that we saw within Goku on Namek and we saw with Final Form Frieza, and that we saw with Super Saiyan Trunks upon his arrival in the story.
Yeah, a lot of people have trouble with this estimation because just the idea that Piccolo got so much more powerful than he was during those 3 years is just hard for people to wrap their heads around. But again, we have to remember that Piccolo was, at least at one point, Toriyama's favorite character, so he liked to have Piccolo relatively strong compared to the other characters during each of the arcs, at least up until the Buu saga, and then, you know, having him in the mix. So, out of universe, it makes sense for Toriyama to power him up that much, but in universe, when we actually look at Piccolo's history of feats, we know that he has a history of scaling up to his opponents or getting much stronger through training under a quick period of time. In Dragon Ball, when someone trains under a much stronger trainer, they get far more powerful than they would on their own. We saw this even with the Z fighters when they were training under Kami before the fight against the Saiyans, where all of them surpassed Raditz. Look at Vegeta, even in Dragon Ball Super's continuity, when he trained with Whis for 6 months, and he surpassed Goku after Goku absorbed the power of Super Saiyan God. So for Piccolo to train under Super Saiyan Goku for 3 years, it makes sense for him not only to get more powerful than Frieza on Namek, but also Goku on Namek, because we know that Goku is more powerful than he was on Namek, especially after those 3 years. And then when Piccolo actually sees action shortly after this, after Krillin has already seen the power of Super Saiyan Trunks, Goku, and Vegeta, Krillin still says, "Wow, Piccolo is so powerful, that he's almost as strong as a Super Saiyan. And of course, all those Super Saiyans are more powerful than Goku on Namek.
One thing to also back up just how strong Piccolo was during this section of the story is the fact that, as Mike pointed out, he was training with Gohan and with Goku. And once you get to the battle with 19 and Goku, it's pretty interesting that when Goku transforms into a Super Saiyan, Piccolo right off the bat knows that something is wrong, and he's the only one who could tell. Later in the story, Gohan could tell as well, those being the only two people who had knowledge of full power Super Saiyan Goku. And what's interesting is that during this portion of the fight, Piccolo is constantly tapping his finger, pulling a Vegeta from the Buu Saga, where he doesn't know what Goku's doing. And that kind of gives off an implication to me that he could very easily go in there and defeat 19 as well. Again, it just backs up his relative strength to that of the Super Saiyans of the early Android Saga. Now, something that's very interesting about 19 and 20 is the fact that 19 may have been weaker than Android 20, because when they first show up, Android 20 absorbs the energy of Yamcha. However, during the battle with Goku and Vegeta, 19 takes their energy. And what's interesting is the implication of that entire scene and later in the story is that Piccolo might have actually been able to take out 19 and 20, as Android 20 still saw himself as being superior to 19 even after post-absorptions, even though Android 20 did absorb a little bit of Piccolo's strength. But again, it just goes into the favor of Piccolo being on the level, or at least relative to that, of a full power Super Saiyan Goku and surpassing the Trunks that we saw in the early stages of the Android Saga during his fight with Frieza and King Cold, because he had, I guess, enough confidence to take on two androids who in his head were stronger than Trunks and would also later absorb energy from different people.
Yeah, so that leads into the actual fight against Android 20. And this is after Android 20, as you said, absorbed the power of Yamcha and some of Piccolo's power as well. But despite this, Piccolo utterly dominates him after taking off his weighted clothing. And we get a statement from Piccolo explaining also why he's able to do this. Because apparently Piccolo, when he was training under Goku, learned how to utilize his ki in such a way where he'd be able to significantly increase the power he's putting out through short bursts, which is kind of a similar idea to what happens with the Kaioken, where in a very brief instance, you can put out a significant amount of power. But beside that, the fact is that Piccolo not only was more powerful than Android 20, but at the same time, he is someone who has far greater ki control, which allows him to also go far beyond whatever specific power level he would have had at the time to deal even more damage. So he uses this to, like I said, utterly dominate Jiro, even cutting off one of his arms. And then at this point, we have Piccolo actually wondering, are these androids weaker than we were told, or did we simply get too strong? Which, that question in and of itself must show you that they were pushing themselves so much and getting such big boosts in power over those 3 years that they actually probably overcompensated for how strong they thought the androids would be. Of course, when we get to Android 17 and 18, it makes those boosts irrelevant. But compared to 19 and 20, they're just easily above them. And when Piccolo starts dominating Jiro is really a shit gets real moment where we really see just how strong this guy has gotten over those 3 years.
Also, to add on to what Mike was talking about when it comes to Piccolo using his energy in short bursts, not only is that a similar principle to the Kaioken, but it's also a similar principle to the idea that Vegeta and Goku can jump in and out of their transformations, like God into Blue and Blue into God, back and forth to utilize different levels of power and speed while conserving stamina and conserving their ki. So again, it just goes to show how much of an intelligent fighter Piccolo was even back in the Android Saga.
So after the defeat of the Z Fighters at the hands of the far superior androids, Piccolo came up with a plan, which was to go to Kami's lookout and merge with his former other half in order to gain the strength necessary to overcome these threats. And after this merger, Piccolo got way more powerful than before, to the point where he was even more powerful than the Super Saiyans at the time. However, there are a number of factors that go together with this merging, such as how exactly it works. Is it similar to Namekian merging, where there is some kind of multiplier that Kami gave to Piccolo, because Piccolo did use his own body for this merger? Or, in this case, is is it simply that when the two of them merge together, they go back to the strength of the nameless Namekian? Or perhaps even on top of that, does Piccolo's current strength get added to it? And I think in this case, the latter is probably the answer, because right after Piccolo leaves to go merge with Kami, we have a statement from Krillin who explains to Tien what's happening, where he says that Piccolo's going in the direction of Kami's lookout to merge with him, and because of how strong Piccolo is right now, if he merges with him and gets even stronger, then he's going to be a super Namekian. And that's exactly what we see after that. So, how much stronger do you think that Piccolo actually was at this point than the other Super Saiyans?
Right off the bat, it's easy to say that he far surpassed them. And a good example of this is not only the battle with Imperfect Cell, but is also a statement that comes right after that. When Vegeta shows up, Vegeta is absolutely shocked at the power of Piccolo. Vegeta showed up because all the fighters were gathering. Piccolo was explaining to them what Cell was because he has the knowledge of Kami now, and Kami's been watching over this threat for some time as it grew. So as he was telling everybody the threat of Cell and how powerful he might become if he gets his hands on the androids, Piccolo just gets upset that he let this monster go. And as he powers up, Vegeta saw a power that he never thought he would ever see again. And this is interesting because, if you guys remember, Vegeta just got his ass handed to him by Android 18, yet he's actually trembling at the thought of how strong Piccolo is. Yeah, you could say he's more so pissed off that a Namekian surpassed a Super Saiyan, but nonetheless, he was still thoroughly impressed at just how strong Piccolo had become as a Super Namekian. So Mike, it's pretty easy to say that he's far stronger than Vegeta at that point, because Android 18 could have, if she wanted to, one-shotted Vegeta if she wasn't playing around with him. And the fact that he's over here just shocked at the strength of Piccolo, knowing that you have Android 17 and 18 out there who could do that to him, that just goes to show how strong Piccolo is.
Yeah, and that's actually something that pushes Vegeta, Trunks, and eventually Goku into trying to surpass the Super Saiyan wall. That not only are the androids more powerful than the Super Saiyan, but so is Piccolo now. And speaking of the androids, we see Piccolo's power in action as he goes and fights against the stronger of the two androids in Android 17. And honestly, when it comes to his power compared to 17, I would say that Piccolo was actually more powerful. Maybe not a significant amount more powerful, but just based upon his performance against 17 and some of the big attacks that he whips out, like the Hellzone Grenade and the Light Grenade. In the case of the Hellzone Grenade, I feel like Piccolo probably would have beaten 17 right there if he didn't have his barrier. But in the case of the Light Grenade, 17 didn't even try to put the barrier up. He just jumped the hell out of the way. So for me, that definitely cements that he probably could have won. Not to mention that Piccolo is a more intelligent fighter with the mind of Nail and Kami combined with his own. And the fact that Piccolo has the Mafuba and some other abilities that he doesn't use. Like, can Piccolo split himself into like 100 different Piccolos and just like smother 17? I don't really know. I'm sure that he has human lungs, so maybe Piccolo could just put his fingers, like extend them all the way down to 17's lungs and choke him out. That would definitely be an interesting way to win, but that seems more like something that'd be in JoJo than Dragon Ball.
Right.
Piccolo right there is already incredibly powerful. Of course, he gets surpassed when Vegeta and Trunks go into the time chamber. However, after that, Piccolo enters the time chamber himself in preparation to fight against Perfect Cell at the Cell Games. And I feel like here is perhaps one of the biggest boosts that Piccolo receives that a lot of people really underestimate, because a lot of people continue to say even now that Piccolo during the Cell Games was weaker than Semi-Perfect Cell. However, when you actually look at the scene when Piccolo exits the time chamber, especially in the anime version, just look at Trunks' reaction, because it tells the whole story. Trunks, who is arguably more powerful than Vegeta, you see him shocked by how powerful Piccolo became, which to me kind of implies that maybe Piccolo got more powerful than Trunks and Vegeta's current strength at that time before they went back into the time chamber. And on top of that, we see Piccolo in action later during the Cell Games when he's fighting against the Cell Juniors.
If you've been watching the videos that Mike and I have put out over the last few years, you would know that we've been trying to tell everybody, yes, when you get to the Buu Saga, it is the Saiyan show. But in the Cell Saga, yes, the humans are not of that much use, but Piccolo is right there with them. And people have to understand that because the Cell Juniors tells the entire story. Everybody is getting their ass handed to them by the Cell Juniors. Everybody. Even Goku, who is weakened and beaten down from his fight with Perfect Cell, even he's getting thrown around by the Cell Juniors. And yet, Piccolo, Trunks, Trunks, and Vegeta are the only three that are able to combat them, and at the end of that entire scuffle, they're the only three characters standing on their own two feet. That just goes to show how strong Piccolo has become. Now, I want you guys to understand this. I'm going to paint a picture for you. Take what Mike just said. You have a character in Trunks, a character who was a Super Saiyan and who dominated Frieza and King Cold, a character who went into the Room of Spirit and Time and trained alongside Vegeta, a guy who took it to semi-perfect Cell and then who tried to take it to perfect Cell, and then you have him and utter awe of just how strong Piccolo is after coming out of the Room of Spirit and Time. If you really wanted to, you could take Trunks post training in the Room of Spirit and Time a second time, put him up against Piccolo during the Cell games, and you could probably make a good argument that Piccolo could hold his own against Trunks. Now, obviously, there would be a power difference, but you could argue it could be so minor that due to Piccolo's arsenal, all the techniques under his belt, all the stuff that he can do, his regeneration, the fact that he has Kami within him, a literal god, he's super intelligent, you could argue that he could take the victory from Trunks. And that's saying something. And I think people have to understand that about Piccolo is that, yes, the Saiyans did outclass the humans, but Piccolo was also right there beside them during the Cell games. Maybe not Gohan and Goku, but Vegeta and Trunks, definitely.
Even though I feel like I'd probably say that Piccolo was not as powerful as Vegeta and Trunks, the fact that Piccolo could still hold his own against these two fighters who went to the time chamber a second time shows you that he's no joke at all at this point. So overall, I think that we showed in this video just how incredibly powerful Piccolo became, not only during the 3 years of training, but during the Cell Saga itself. With Piccolo at the end of the arc being comparable to Vegeta and Trunks in their most powerful Super Saiyan forms. Unfortunately, after this point, Piccolo didn't exactly go on to stay at a competitive level with the other characters. However, just because of that doesn't mean that Piccolo wasn't a badass throughout the series up until that point. And even now, he still continues to be a badass in Dragon Ball Super, to where he seems like he's relatively comparable to Ultimate Gohan at points, which is certainly an even more gigantic boost than before. So that goes to show you that this guy is still capable of being relevant, and maybe, just maybe, if he trained under Whis and he had the exact same kind of train that Goku and Vegeta did, Piccolo might be number one again. Make sure to subscribe and enable all notifications so you can stay up to date with all of my videos. Thanks for watching, and make sure to stick around because there's a lot more to come in the future.
Yeah, and you better subscribe.